Let us now proceed to the last step in this section, which is creating and configuring the UI component for the account form. So the way we write the UI component is to write a component and then do a post to this slash UI components. So this is where we should be posting that. Since we are taking a periodic approach of developing the UI component, let us develop the entire component, and once we do that, we come back and post that component here to the UI components. Let me use a temporary file to create the UI component. So I'll name this as UI component dot JSON, and using this file we will create the entire component. And I will also be hosting this in the asset section. You can take a look at the complete component file after it is developed. So let us get started with the development of this. So let us start the exercise of coding the UI component for the customer information by giving certain core attributes first. So the name of this particular UI component is account-form, and the model name to which it will be bound is account, and we are now in the development of this account-form.html, which is nothing but the template. So therefore the template is account-form.html, and we do not want any fields to be injected automatically, so therefore we are making this as false, because we will be following a completely custom configuration approach, so we don't want any auto rendering of the fields to happen. So therefore these are the first four set of core attributes that we have included. The next step is we shall include a array called fields, and this is the array where we will be developing all the properties which are required for the fields and the respective divs in which they should be rendered, and other validations which are required for the UI component. At this point of time, we will take a moment and then take a look at the divs. So in the OE block validator, which is meant for the customer information, we have two divs which are set up. One is personal, second is address, and these two divs are declared as part of the template. Now, in the UI component that we are going to develop now, we will make sure that these are the fields which will get rendered as part of this particular divs. So, that configuration is what we are going to do as part of the UI component. So, let's get started. First, let's get started with a simple field. The field ID is first name, and this is nothing but the property name which is drawn from the account model. So just in case you're in doubt, you could go to this account model, and you could see that the name of this property is first name. So that is exactly what you should be mentioning here. That is the field ID. And the second question that you need to configure is, where should this particular first name be rendered? So therefore this should be inside, rendered inside this container called personal. And if you just look at the account form, so, and if you go to the block validator that is responsible for rendering the customer information block, you see that there is a div ID called personal which is set up here. It is under this div ID whose value is equal to personal, this particular field ID called first name, which is just nothing but a property from this account model, should be rendered. And while it is rendering, by default it will take the field ID's value as the label. So in case we need to customize that, that can be done with this label property. So here we are saying that neatly it is first space name. So this is the label that will be given at the time of rendering of the first name. So we need to carry out the similar steps for the rest of the fields now. The next set of fields that we are going to configure is the last name. We follow exactly the same logic what we followed in the case of first name. So we have a field ID, which is nothing but a property from this account dot JSON, and this should be rendered into the container personal, and we have this label here. Now the next one is field ID is date of birth, so that's also available as part of the account.json, and the container that should be rendered is personal, and the max is today, so therefore you will not be able to take up any date after today. And similarly, you could also set the min property if you like, and the label is a date of birth, and then the placeholder is a select date, so there will be a label that comes in and then gets attached in the field. So these are the two fields that we have configured now. The next field that we are going to configure is gender, and this should be a part of the personal div ID, and the label is gender, and there is a placeholder for this which says select value. Now you could see that we want the UI type or the control that should be used in order to accept this input should be a OE radio group. So this is the one that we want, and because this is a OE radio, we would like the male and female to be a part of sequence here, and that gets documented, or that gets configured with the help of list data. So therefore, when the gender field is getting rendered, it will construct a OE radio group, and as part of that, it will render these two list items, which is male and female. So this is how you could configure any other control that you would require in order to configure as part of the UI component. The next field that we are going to configure is country, and this is the container where this should be rendered. And also recall from the earlier discussion that for the country, we have used this ref code type to be country. So therefore, the values for this, because of this, will directly rendered out of that source that you have mentioned already. So it is going to be a reference code which is drawn from the data set, and then that will be rendered as part of the list data here. Let us now quickly add the rest of the controls for the personal div. And so these are mother name, and it should be rendered in personal. And then you have PAN, you have Aadhaar number, and then you have email. For email, you are also attaching a pattern here. It should start with capital A to Z, or 0 to A to Z small, and then 0 to 9, and it should definitely have a at the rate and followed by this pattern. So in case you are not doing that, then this particular error message should get triggered. So this is how you attach custom validations for the UI component. So this completes the field ID configurations for the personal div. Let us now configure the address related fields. So first we will get started with line 1. The container is different here. Hitherto we were using a container called personal. Now we are going to use this other container from this account form template, which is over this one. So this is the area into which this particular control should be rendered. So that's why it is the container is address here, and we have attached a pattern here, and then there's an error message, and the label for this is it is flat number slash block slash society. Similarly, we could configure the other fields now. So we have line 2 that is configured here, line 3, and city. And also for city, observe that the values will essentially come from a ref code pattern. So we have mentioned the ref code reference here, which is a city here, and that's configured already. And therefore, if you observe that we are not giving any list data here, and we have the state and the zip code which is mentioned over here. So these are the different fields that we would like to get rendered in the customer information page in the two divs that we have mentioned, which are personal and address. To sum up, what we have achieved as part of this customer information page is we have highlighted this particular section called customer information. This is happening because of the iron selector configuration. And we have detailed a section where we are capturing the personal details, and then we are getting rendered that into a personal div tag. And also the correspondence and local address details are getting delivered into this address div. And we have also set up this navigation to the previous page and then navigation to the next page. So this is what we have achieved now. Now what we need to do is we need to capture the account type information, which is the next step.